I love money. I love money more than I love the things it can buy.
Does that surprise you? Money. It don't care whether I'm good or not. It don't care whether I snore or not. It don't care which God I pray to. There are only three things in this world with that kind of unconditional acceptance. Dogs, donuts, and money. Only money is better. You know why? Because it don't make you fat and it don't poop all over the living room floor. There's only one thing I like better. Other people's money.
Things out. I thought that someone might be Nick Leeson.
Oh! That's
what I love about Asia. Anyone can make it. It doesn't matter which stupid school you went to.
I just made 2,000 quid.
We are gonna make so much money.
In the AIDS account. The losses are over $10 million.
Keep your voice down. Everything will be all right so long as we balance the books by the end of the month.
Gamble.
That's all the market is. One giant casino.
Those losses are getting out of control.
What's bothering me is where you got all the money to actually pay us, OK, in the first place.
I've got an unauthorised position.
They want to check on these numbers, iron out these funding problems once and for all.
I, Nicholas Leeson, have lost 50 million quid.
Become an employee of this firm, you will make your first million within 3 years. I'm gonna repeat that. You will make $1 million.
At the stock trading house of JT Marlin, a new generation is building their fortune.
So I want you to go out, buy yourselves a new car. Go buy yourself a house.
We're superstars now.
They say money can't buy happiness. Look at the smile on my face. Ear to ear, baby.
This is Chris Marlin over at JT Marlin.
This stock is blowing up right now. The whole firm's going nuts. Hold on, let me open up the door to my office. See that, Doc?
Give me the 2,000 shares.
Done.
A sale is made on every call you make.
Sky's the limit.
I figured out how Michael's making his money.
We're selling stock for companies that don't exist.
I want my money back.
I'm sorry, Harry. I can't do that.
You're destroying people's lives.
I want to get out of it.
Anybody who tells you money is the root of all evil doesn't have any.
Wall Street has a gambling problem. They never learn anything.
We don't do this now. We won't have an economy on Monday.
What are we, crossing our fingers?
I'm sorry, let me see if I understand this. Are you directing us to put Lehman into bankruptcy?
Give us a moment.
He's muted.
What the hell was that?
You guys have no idea what's going on out here.
It's another bailout.
Why? The depression of the 1930s.
You want too big to fail? Here it is.
Mr. Dale, these are extraordinary times, as you very well must know.
I don't understand.
The majority of this floor is being let go today.
Eric, I'm very sorry.
I was working on something, but they wouldn't let me finish it. So take a look at it. Be careful.
I need you guys to come back up here.
Wait a second.
Just trust me, okay? I need you guys back here now.
Wait a minute, what am I looking at?
This figure here.
Whoa, is that?
It gets ugly in a hurry.
Is that figure right?
Looks pretty right to me.
There are $8 trillion of paper around the world relying on that equation.
But we were wrong.
No, you mean you were wrong.
Sir, if those assets decrease by just 25%, that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.
How long would it take to clear that from our books?
You cannot be doing what you're thinking of doing.
Sell it all today.
You're selling something that you know has no value.
So that we may survive.
There are three ways to make a living in this business. Be first, be smarter, or cheat.
Look at these people wandering around with absolutely no idea what's about to happen.
You're a very important piece of this puzzle. Are you in on this?
I can tell you that people are going to say some very nasty things about what we do here today.
If we're going down, and you damn well know it'll be together.
I'm not sure that I do know that.
The ground is shifting below our feet.
Remember this day, boys. Remember this day.
Remember the 80s?
Money.
Yeah, right. Tons of it.
When greed was good.
All we want you to do is make us as rich as possible, Ross.
And luxury a necessity.
What you need is an unlisted horse.
Meet F. Ross Johnson.
I picked it up my first day in New York.
CEO extraordinaire.
I'm going to buy out the company.
He wants to buy out RJR Nabisco.
What?
He's got a plan.
Every penny you think I'm... way here comes back to us dressed up like a nickel. I'm talking about putting a mountain of money into everybody's pocket right now.
But the sharks are circling.
We have to be in on this, Peter. You understand?
Kravis will eat you alive if you let him in.
Our move? What do you think? Napalm.
The press is closing in.
Nervous, are you?
Hell no. I always take a leak with my flight clothes.
And the stakes are getting sky high.
$2.5 billion, Ross.
We'll be looking for $17 billion.
$20 billion.
James Gardner.
Well, all I want from bankers is a new calendar every year, and all I care about lawyers is they're back in their coffins before the sun comes up.
In a story that reveals the lowdown on high finance.
Now I know what the F in F. Ross Johnson stands for.
Barbarians at the Gate, the HBO original movie.
Banks have conditioned us to trust them. And what have we got from that? 25% interest rates on credit cards. They have screwed us on student loans that we can never get out from under.
When the banks committed the greatest fraud in U.S. history.
No one is paying attention.
It's unbelievable.
Four outsiders risked it all to take them down.
We're going to make the big banks hurt.
How can the banks let this happen?
It's fueled by stupidity.
But that's not stupidity, that's fraud.
Tell me the difference between stupid and illegal and I'll have my wife's brother arrested.
Banks got greedy and we can profit off of their stupidity.
Do you have any idea what you're up against?
We have to act now.
So Mike Barry, who doesn't wear shoes, knows more than the federal government.
Dr. Mike Barry, yes he does.
I worry about you.
I'm fine. No, my cab.
What do you mean?
My cab, schmuck. I love you, honey. I'll talk to you later.
There's some shady stuff going down. God, this is intimate.
I feel like I'm financially inside of you or something.
Okay.
If we're right, people lose homes. People lose jobs.
The banks have more incentives than greed.
You're wrong.
We can do everything straight and still go broke.
We need to go all in.
The ratings agencies, the banks, the government, they're all asleep at the wheel.
You think this is a game?
This is a once-in-a-lifetime deal.
I'm thinking.
Sometimes there's nothing you can do. It's scary.
The banks have defrauded the American people. Now we can kick them in the teeth.
Okay, here we go.
I had the most absurd nightmare. I was poor and no one liked me.
I know what you're thinking. You see Foggy and Ben? We can make it, baby! Me and you!
Dan Aykroyd and Eddie Murphy are trading places. Help! Help!
Hey, I don't want your bag, man.
Help! 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 Help!
I'll bet that that man could run our company as well as your young Winthorpe.
Are we talking about a wager, Randolph?
Is there a problem, officer?
Oh, Winthorpe. I'm glad your parents are not alive to see this.
Wait! Now this is totally preposterous! I'm not a thief!
Here we are, William.
Take off your clothes.
You are making a career decision here.
Take off your clothes.
Did you hear what this man said to me? I have witnesses. This man is physically threatening me.
Hey, Randy, Morty, this is nice. I like this.
We are commodities brokers, William. Commodities are agricultural products, like wheat, which is used to make bread, pork bellies, which is used to make bacon, which you might find in a bacon and lettuce and tomato sandwich.
I'm considering going long on April wheat. What do you think, Valentine?
Freeze, Slimeball!
Moi?
Put that gun away at once, Winthorpe. You lost your mind?
Dan Aykroyd, Eddie Murphy. They're not just getting rich, they're getting even.
Do you have any better ideas?
Yeah, you know, it occurs to me that the best way you hurt rich people is by turning them into poor people.
Dan Aykroyd. Eddie Murphy. Trading Places.
From the director of Platoon, Wall Street.
Stock is plummeting. When it hits 18, buy it all.
Something big is going down. I want to know where he goes and what he sees. I want you, pal, to fill out the missing picture.
Mr. Gecko, that's not exactly what I do.
Where you can trade your honor.
I could lose my license. That's inside information.
For power.
If you're not inside, you are outside.
I know what this guy's all about. Greed. There is no nobility in poverty anymore, Dad.
Greed is good. Greed works.
What makes you tick, bud?
The fear of being poor. That's all gonna change. So I'm catching the express.
All right, Mr. Gecko, you got me.
Trade your peace of mind.
What's in it for moi? More money than you ever dreamed of.
Just the beginning, pal.
If any trouble does arise, you are on your own. The trail does stop with you.
For a piece of the action.
The richest 1% of this country owns half our country's wealth, $5 trillion.
All it takes is a little inside information.
I don't care where or how you get it.
I think you owe me.
And you can trade everything you believe in.
He's using you, kid. You're too blind to see it.
For everything you've ever wanted.
I get a strange call from the SEC. They asked to see my records. This is heavy, bud.
I don't know where you get your information, son, but I don't like it.
Michael Douglas.
Why do you need to wreck this company?
Because it's wreckable, all right?
Charlie Sheen.
When does it all end, huh? How many yachts can you water ski behind? How much is enough?
Daryl Hannah.
You may find out one day that when you've had money and lost it, it's much worse than never having had it at all.
Martin Sheen.
What I see is a jealous old machinist who can't stand the fact that his son's become more successful than he has.
What you see is a guy who never measured a man's success by the size of his wallet.
An Oliver Stone film. Wall Street.
My name is Jordan Belfort. The year I turned 26, I made $49 million, which really pissed me off because it was three shy of $1 million a week.
We're making a name for ourselves.
Nobody knows if the stock is going to go up, down, sideways, or in circles. You know what a Fugazi is?
Oh, Fugazi. It's a fake.
Hey, Fugazi, Fugazi. It's a wazzy, it's a woozy, it's a fairy dust.
Was all this legal? Absolutely not. We were making more money than we knew what to do with.
We don't work for you, man.
Yeah, my money taped to your boobs. Technically, you do work for me.
What's wrong, Daddy? But watching you
bring home. Oh, my God. FBI, any kind of booze you might want.
No, the Bureau forbids us from drinking.
Duh. So follow me, you could about to go. I'm doing 500, I'm out of control. But there's nowhere to go. And there's no way to slow. If I knew what I knew in the past, I would have been like that on your. How does this actually work?
There's a big money sign.
They get launched at the target, they stick.
Yeah. This is their gift, okay? They're built to be thrown like a lawn dart.
One, two, three! Stop.
Okay? Safety first.
Safety is first. Okay. We don't want to get a bad reputation.